Many a time has there been a successful game that's succeeded despite a lack of content from the community in the form of mods. Kingdom Come was just that, an incredibly in-depth, immersive storyline that expected players to work their way through the world alone. Then once complete, you're done. Granted, there were a number of DLCs and add-ons branching out with different characters and quests, yet the game that Warhorse created started and ended with them. But whilst that was the result, I'm not sure that was really ever their intention. Modding tools were released for the game and ambitious developers were promising big things. But as world champion Tevin Farmer says,
We promise a lot of things, sometimes we don't deliver.
So what happened? I made a full rundown of the many reasons that KCD and its modding community failed in a previous video if you want to go and check that out. And I mentioned in that how later I was going to return on a new video and give an update on perhaps the biggest and most hyped of these mods, the Seven Kingdoms, a Game of Thrones total conversion for Kingdom Come. The mod was building up to be something massive, but then all of a sudden went dark. And since that video, more has come out. Why the mod stopped development and the issues during its creation, and why inevitably it ceased to exist. So, what really happened to Kingdom Come Deliverance's Game of Thrones mod? By the way, before we get into the video, a little nudge here. Games Planet are having a 50% off sale for Kingdom Come at the moment. I literally just noticed as I was researching this video. So if you want to go and help support the channel, pick it up through my link and you'll get a massive discount. The Seven Kingdoms mud and ash mod was set to be a complete total conversion, transforming the world of Bohemia into Westeros, set in the Riverlands during the War of the Five Kings that we know from the books and TV show. Smart, right? Bohemia in Kingdom Come pretty much looks like the Riverlands already. Despite this, there were plans for a full overhauled map, a custom made to replicate that of Game of Thrones, completely recreating the fantasy world in Kingdom Come. It's kind of the perfect game for it as well. I mean, think about it. If you were wanting a Game of Thrones game, what would you want it to prioritize? Immersion, deep in-depth storytelling, interesting characters that live their own lives without you even being there to guide them, and of course a complex first-person combat system using intricate weapons and armor designs, right? I mean, that's literally what Kingdom Come Deliverance is, yet it just did it in a more historical setting. The translation to Game of Thrones doesn't need much of a stretch of your imagination. The mod itself came from a bit of frustration in the development team, however. Having previously made the Seven Kingdoms mod and the Rise of Mordor mods for Attila Total War, they felt like that game didn't really fit the style they had in mind for their total conversions, and Kingdom Come looked like a much better translation to get across their ideas for the reasons I've just explained. So the team was set, the pedigree was there, and the ambitious idea was ready to be executed, yet it never came to be. And it's really sad that it never happened, as it would have had some really cool things like players being able to completely choose their own fate, join whichever army they wanted, whether it was the Lannisters, the North, or the Riverlands, and decide the direction of the playthrough. It sounds like everything I ever wanted in a Game of Thrones mod. But years after, there was still silence. We did get a few updates here and there with map and asset showcases on their YouTube channel. I mean, the Northern armor looked rugged, dirty, and worn. The Lannisters looked pristine, ruby red to hide the blood of their felled enemy. Everything was moving along and shaping up to be something quite special. Yet a few months passed and we heard nothing. A year went by, then all of a sudden their Twitter and their Discord disappeared. So people were wondering, what's going on here? Then it took until 2021 for a comment on their ModDB page to give some sort of answer to come forward. People were asking, of course, where it went, and the developers replied, saying as follows: no longer working on it, kids, work, etc. It happens, unfortunately. And that was it. Our first confirmation the mod... Fuck off! And that was it. Our first confirmation that the mod was abandoned. Cries ripped through the fabric of time. Across the galaxy, you could hear Game of Thrones nerds screaming to the heavens. Why, oh why? You were the chosen one. How could you do this? Or that might just have been me. But it gets spicier. Yes, yes, you might want to stick around for this one, because recently, as you saw, I've made a video on why mods in Kingdom Come Deliverance failed. Many of the reasons I thought, and I gave some examples as to why they didn't really kick off the way that I think many people expected them to. And one of the examples I gave was the Seven Kingdoms mod that we're talking about here. And lo and behold, the dev team themselves responded in the comments, letting people know what actually happened on the inside and why the team struggled through development. Many of the comments on that video was telling me how stupid I was, and the only reason modding failed was because CryEngine alone was this impossible thing to mod on. I'm not exactly sure how founded those arguments are. Yet the Seven Kingdoms team themselves noted how the engine wasn't really the issue. It wasn't all that bad to mod on itself. But Warhorse, the developers made it trickier, stating that they made loads of in-house tools to make the game. These weren't shared with the community for understandable reasons, and it made it almost impossible to efficiently get similar results when making a mod for themselves. Many of the workflows that Warhorse took in order to create and implement their character models apparently made it really hard to change with custom meshes, and it was a mix of these proprietary tools and lacking documentation to understand the way it was that made it so hard. But you may be wondering, hey, didn't you just show a load of custom armors and models that the mod were expecting to use? Yeah, you might have seen a lot of these on screen and they look fantastic. But according to the team, it was such a hassle just to get in a few of these models into the game that carrying on at the scale originally planned seems like an impossible task at this point. The reply goes on to report that the team itself was also lacking a little bit in terms of extra help and programmers, but I'm sure these things could probably have been sourced if there was that will to continue with such a feat. Yet Kingdom Come just wasn't gonna let it happen. As I mentioned in my first video, it's not exactly the fault of Warhorse. Their aim was to make Kingdom Come Deliverance. Opening the title up for modding was a secondary thought, because why wouldn't it be? Don't get me wrong, it's a shame for the modding community and what it could have been, but I don't blame Warhorse for this. The focus was on the main native game, and that should always come first. And perhaps if they did try and make the IP more open to modders without all the custom tools, the base game of Kingdom Come might not have been as successful as it eventually ended up being. And to the Seven Kingdoms devs, thank you so much for commenting and giving more information on my previous video. Me and I'm sure a lot of people at home were really looking forward to the mod, but at the end of the day, no one can really blame you for deciding to let it go considering the circumstances of what Warhorse gave you to work with. As far as I am aware, the Attila Total War 7 Kingdoms mod is still going strong and just had a massive update. I've played it in the past and I'm looking forward to seeing where it goes next. And honestly, people could hold out for a bigger modding community in the next title in the Kingdom Come franchise, yet maybe it was never meant to be. Sometimes mods just aren't paramount to a game's success. The game can stand alone just fine without them. Yeah, it is great when you have all that extra community made content, but I think in this case it could just be a matter of the fact that Kingdom Come and all the games to come in the series by Warhorse just were never really meant to be modded, and instead enjoyed just how they are. Which to me at least doesn't sound all that bad. But please let me know what you think down below. Thank you so much for watching, and remember, if you do want to pick up KCD for a discounted price, I do have a great deal for you below. This video isn't sponsored in any way by anyone, but it does help the channel. It is an affiliate link, so be aware of that. But of course, it's Games Planet. Everything is 100% legit. It's one of the good ones, like Humble or Greenman Gaming, so you can be sure that you're helping and supporting the devs as well whenever you use them. But leave a like on the video if you enjoyed it. Leave a dislike if you didn't. But until then, I'll see you in the next one.